Good evening, everyone. My name is Thomas Watts, and it is my absolute pleasure to be the director of the Chillicothe High School Orchestra's Concert Orchestra and Symphonic Orchestra. Tonight, we are going to be presenting a preview of our OMEA. More information can be found about that in your program, Large Group State Performance. There's going to be two parts to this concert. This first part isn't listed in your program, but the first thing that we are going to do is going to sound completely absurd for a concert. The students are going to flip a piece of music over that's on their stand. They have never seen this piece before. I have never played this piece with an orchestra before. They are going to have 4 minutes on a timer to look at it, discuss it, airplay, as we talk about it. The only thing they can't physically do is actually play their instruments. It's going to look entirely bizarre, but it's exactly what they're going to be doing in front of one of the four judges next Saturday. We'll talk about that more in a little bit, but does everyone have music on their stand?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, go ahead and flip it over. I'm not starting your time yet.
To explain, it's one and two, okay? And we're not segregating movement three. Look at the first two. Make sense? Does everyone have the correct part of that? Does anyone have, like, viola and they should have violin or something? Okay. I am going to start for 4 minutes. I work. Now,
following 4 minutes by themselves, they're going to have 4 additional minutes with me, the director. I might have them clap a few rhythms, maybe bow through some tricky passages, maybe point out some difficult things in the music that might throw them off. If you're looking for something to do with the next 8 minutes of your life, might I recommend? It seems the Chillicothe Orchestra Boosters are right outside selling Cheryl's Cookies for $2 per cookie. And I will tell you, quite frankly, you cannot get them at Cheryl's Cookies for $2 per cookie. So if you're interested in supporting the efforts of the Chillicothe Orchestra Boosters and thereby the students that you'll hear performing tonight, feel free to check that out. I will see you in a few minutes. Things that the students are looking for right now in their music include things like maybe the key signature, which affects the nature of the notes they're playing. Does that change while they're playing? The time signature in terms of how many pulses per measure and kind of the feeling of the piece. Does that change throughout the piece? They're also checking out musical expression as well. Does it grow? Does it dwindle, things of that nature. What's interesting about this process is what the judges are looking for is, one, they're testing the students' musical literacy, and two, they're testing the students' ability to think creatively, to think musically, and do all of that as an ensemble, not as individuals, it turns out to be surprisingly a difficult obstacle for the students to overcome. This is something we practice regularly in class, discussing different strategies for sight reading new pieces of music, different strategies for, hey, if you mess this up the first time and you have to play it again later, well, maybe improve it the second time. Judges will notice things like that. Their time is almost up, and then they'll have a few minutes with me kind of guiding them through the music, and then for the first time, you will hear this piece.
Four, one, and three, and one, two, and 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 four, one, and three, and one, two, and
text played one more time in movement one. That's right, the first.
All right, now we are going to transition into playing. After we play our sight read, we're going to go ahead and play our concert set that's listed in your program. I'm also saying this so that the people that are helping me selling cookies tonight can come out and see the concert orchestra perform. The piece they will be sight reading is called the School Time Suite, featuring two movements. So you'll hear movement one and movement two tonight. So for the first time ever of concert orchestra, please enjoy two movements from the School Time Suite. Thank you. I wanted you to kind of witness that process and experience that, because you won't get to see that when you go see us perform at large group next Saturday. And so after their stage performance, they'll actually go to a separate room with a separate judge who hasn't heard them play yet, so it's non-biased. And then they will sight read a piece in that same manner, right? Now the judge is aware that the students have never seen the piece before, so there is a little bit of leeway there, but it is impressive to see them going, oh, that's that key signature, I gotta watch out for that note. We had moments where, oh, whoa, I'm supposed to be playing, and rather than shutting down, you just push through it and play the piece, right? It's okay to work through those mistakes. It's actually, it's kind of a nice triumph for them in that sense. So at this point, I'm going to stop talking because I won't talk next week either. You are simply going to experience the concert set that they have been working on over the last 5.5 weeks. This is the shortest turnaround we actually get for a concert. So to see the music at the level that it is at is nothing short of impressive. So without further ado, I'm going to check tuning, and then here is Concert Orchestra's OMEA State Large Group Preview.
Thank you.
Thank you. I hope you thoroughly enjoyed the set that they have prepared for you. They have worked so hard, and to see the music where it is right now is incredible. At this time, we're going to have a short scene change. You're going to see the same procedure from Symphonic Orchestra. Concert, you can go ahead and head on down this way with your stuff. Symphonic, once they get off stage, go ahead and join them on stage. You should see the sight reading under some of your chairs, and then we'll make sure everyone has one when we get started, okay? So once again, you'll find the information for OMEA State Large Group Performance in your program. We'll be performing at Reynoldsburg High School, the Livingston Avenue campus, next Saturday. I believe in the program, concert orchestra is at 9:15 a.m. and symphonic orchestra is at 11:10 a.m. Concert orchestra will be competing in Class C, and symphonic orchestra, which you'll hear shortly, will be competing at the next level in Class B. I did get the question from a few parents and guardians. You are allowed to attend that performance at Reynoldsburg. The only part that you can't physically see is the actual sight reading. That's done in a separate room entirely outside of the performance event. Something worth noting, they changed the rules and regulations of large group. I believe this applies to band and choir as well, but I won't speak for certain. They've instructed us after the large group performance to actually have the performer stand, face the audience, and allow for group photos if you would like to take a photo of the group at the actual performance site. And then I've also been made aware that they are going to make a separate recording without the judge's commentary. So the group will have actually a clean recording of their large group performance to keep and listen to and reference and just look back on the good times. So at this point, I think I'll go ahead and step off, let them tune, and then you'll watch that sight reading process one more time.
Thank you.
The piece that Symphonic Orchestra is going to sight read for you today to replicate Class B sight reading is titled North Star to Freedom. Noted in the program notes left by the composer, it's in honor of the Underground Railroad. So please enjoy, for the first time ever, from Symphonic Orchestra, North Star to Freedom. This will actually be the last time you hear me talk this evening, so I will start with a few thank yous. I do want to take some time to thank the Chillicothe Orchestra Boosters for everything they do in supporting the things that the students do. One recent thing they supported is I finally, after many long years, have been able to take the 5th and 6th grade orchestras to see the Columbus Symphony Orchestra. That trip actually happened yesterday. I believe the intermediate school did some kind of social media post about it with plenty of pictures of excited young students getting to see just what is possible with their instruments at the highest level. And of course, a nice Italian lunch never hurt anyone either when it comes to 5th and 6th graders, I'm sure. I do want to also take some time to thank our media department recording the concert this evening. I also want to thank our Chillicothe admin for everything they do in supporting, making sure the students have time to rehearse and have this beautiful space for concerts and everything that's required into preparing for these concerts. Without further ado, please enjoy the Symphonic Orchestra's contest concerts performing in Class B.